throw it in front, and that fish stat by Shaw as it came on to Stastny. And back down. Oh, a collision, and Shaw is down on all fours. Icing is called, and Shaw shaken up.
Oh, an elbow right to the head. Bumped by Girardi. Fast for McDonough. McDonough with a pass to Stephon. McDonough has gone down on the ice, and
got hit. Yeah. I think Komarov got him with an elbow.
And right into Komarov goes Kevin Klein. Challenges him right away. McDonough hurt on the play.
Oh, boy.
Coming off a concussion.
Here it is. He's down, and here it is. Oh, he gets him right in the jaw. Right in the jaw. I mean, that's a bad hit.
Kopetsky for Gotch. Marcel Gotch plays it around deep in the zone and gets after it. Gotch controls. Kopetsky in front with a chance. And did Lundqvist get a piece of it? Kopetsky got tattooed up high. And he is down and banged up.
That turnover, and where does that go? Does it go off the crossbar? Yeah.
Yep.
Goes right off that crossbar in behind Lundqvist.
That's
and then
brutal.
Late hit there just by Nash coming through.
I'd like to know, how is that not a penalty? I mean, that is high. That's suspension worthy.
Well, watch the jump. He leaves his feet. Look how far off the ice he is.
That's not even debatable.
No.
He goes up ice with Nash. Marchand's shot saved by Appleby. He covers up, and Johansson reaches to his face as Marchand went tumbling through. You always have to be concerned that a player might catch the blade of somebody skating a collision like that.
He's trying to create the 2-on-1. Once again, Vatanen's going to take away the pass. Marchand goes for the puck, and then that flying, vicious right elbow as he's fighting his way, trying to get to that second chance.
Nick Bonino, there's a shot by Mata, and a nice leg save. And Olli Mata got knocked down, and he's hurt, and there's a penalty on the play, and Brooks Orpik is going to get it. Ooh, Mata looks woozy.
Yeah, his head hit the ice, I think, when he fell down, Jim. And you could see he's in some trouble. Bonino trying to hold him down. Daly comes in, waits for the trainer. Puck was long gone, and oh yeah, right to the button. And for Orpik following through, when he stopped up, he got him right in the elbow, right on the chin, and down he went.
Thompson gets it in deep. Cogliano in the forecheck, and he bounced off Kreibach. And the Iron Man is hurt. He's really slow to get up. He can't get up right now. Thompson still with the puck, and still they won't stop playing, even though Anaheim has the puck. And Cogliano is clearly hurt. Finally, they whistled the play. He was stopped.
Yeah, I'm shocked that they didn't do it earlier, Jim. You know, there's times when they don't blow the whistle when the defending player is down, when the other team has control, but the mandate seemed to be a guy with no helmet, a bloody nose, and they just allowed the Ducks to continue to go on. Here's the big body of Driba. Oh, the elbow came up as he was going in. He was shooting the puck around. Watch.
Oh,
it's the
yeah.
Follow-through of the shot, though. I don't think there was any intent at all. He was pasted up against the glass.
Michael Backlund on the boards. Cycles it down low. On the sticking on the wall as Giordano got it behind the net. Time Doughty's down in behind the goal. Play continuing, and now Pearson with a big hit on Matthew Tkachuk. Drew Doughty still down on the ice.
Ooh, and there is the elbow right to the head. Okay, we'll have another look at it here. Here comes Doughty. Yep, and there's the left elbow right into the chin.
Upon further review, this much is clear. Naslund was in a vulnerable position. Steve Moore had no interest in playing the puck, and he leaned into the Canuck captain.
Side by side as they enter the zone, in formation, if you will. In behind the net.
Neil went down hard.
Yeah, you hear himself. Right away, you could tell. I don't know if he's out or I don't know what it is. See the right elbow came around, hit him right in the chin. Just knocked him out. Not out, just knocked him a little bit silly.
Brian McLeod, a shot, and Cicerelli sails into the boards. McLeod tries to keep play going. Off for Cicerelli. Cicerelli hit Nylund, and now Nylund goes to work on Cicerelli. Here comes Lucille. Now Savard and Lucille.
There's Bob Rouse. This could be a very important part of the hockey game. We'll have to see how it turns out, but Nyland drilling Cicerelli. Now Cicerelli's in the corner. He's hurt. See, now watch. He's getting up. Now Pohorski's watching him, and now Cicerelli knows he's just been drilled by a cheap shot, so he just charges Nyland, gives him a vicious elbow. Of course, Nyland goes bananas and just starts wailing on Cicerelli. Now Bobby Rouse is going to come in and wipe out Nyland.
Highlights and stats as always, and word of a special show that's originating very soon on Comcast Sportsnet involving the sports junkies. Oh. Simmons was freight trained and stays down. Bumping in was John Erskine, and Simmons is still feeling the effects.
Is up, which is a good sign. Here comes Erskine, the poke check, and there's the finish.
The arm of Erskine. Watch the elbow and forearm. Ow.
And it's right onto the head of the forward.
For Crystal. Crystal trying to go around Murphy and does with one hand, looking short side. Oh, what a hit on Murphy. Behind the net. And Murphy. He's down. Kristic trying to go around Murray, gets a shot on Pete Peters. Then Murray looking at his feet, not watching Dale Hunter coming in, and Dale Hunter gets his elbow up and catches him right in his face. Then Mike Ricci jumps on top of Dale Hunter, but Murphy with his head down trying to find that puck in his skates, and at the last minute you just see his eyes coming up.
But here is Frolik with it. Ounces off his stick, a collision there. Oh, Bolin is shaken up. Back the other way, Carter trying to make something happen. And there, Penner knocks Seabrook right over the top of Hjalmarsson, who was already tied up with Carter.
Let's keep our eye on this left forearm here.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
And these elbow pads are huge, and Penner's strong. That was a forearm elbow right to the side of the head on Bolin.
Moves it around as well, steps into him. There's a hit. Oh, boy.
Oh, man.
Knocked out.
He knocked himself out. I can't believe it. He is... really,
Cam Stewart.
Yeah, Cam Stewart really stung himself. I think you'll see in the replay, Cam Stewart came in behind the Ottawa Senator player and was going to give him a bit of a pop. And I think what happened is Cam's own stick ended up hitting him in the head. Oh boy, there's Cam Stewart, left side of your screen. There he is. Now watch what happens. He loses his balance a little bit. Bingo.
Oh, got an elbow.
Got an elbow. Oh, wow. Oh my goodness, did he ever get nailed by that elbow? Of course, we didn't see that from the first angle. Now we see it, and it's Kevin Dineen. Now, I told you about the grit of Kevin Dineen. There's no doubt that Dineen saw.
And a running back check by Taves. Jonathan Taves covered up for his D-man who had gone in offensively. And Taves just worked his tail out to get back defensively, and wow. That was a sweet play. Now Hossa's down in the middle of the ice. He seems to be a little bit wobbly as he heads to the bench. Well, that's an elbow right to the back of the head from Hansen.
Looked like a forearm shiver. Yeah, right there. He wasn't going for the puck. The puck was in the air, Pat.
With the left hand. Coyle's only 21 years old in his rookie year, born in Weymouth, Massachusetts. Spent 2 years at Boston University.
And you think anyone would play well with Koivu and Parise, but Coyle has a good fit there. He really does fit. Again, on that goal he scored, he just stayed there and stayed around. Cold shoulder here by Dustin Brown. Wow. It looks like Brown play with Bombenville. Bombenville looking for a puck. And there it is. Brown is leaning, and he's bracing for the contact. Bombenville does not expect him to brace. Does he raise his elbow? You see the contact. Wow, I think it's shoulder.
Early by a score of 2-1, the lone Maple Leaf goal by Phil Kessel, whose sister Amanda scored the winning goal in the gold medal game for the World Championships for the United States over Canada last night.
Boy, high hit here by Anton Volchenkov. He leads with his elbow. I mean, this should be a five-minute penalty.
Volchenkov's leaving. Brian Mock's taking him out.
I mean, right there, that's a suspendable hit. There's no doubt about that by Volchenkov. Not a smart play at all.
Oh, who quite often when he gets near the board seems to
bowed down a little bit.
Edler finishes his check, and here's the hit. Well, Duncan, yeah, he sticks the elbow out. It catches Daniel Sedin. Now, right now, all the referees, the ref 2 minute minor to Duncan Keith on this play, and there he goes.
Messier along the boards. Scans the situation. Ooh, good up the puck, but Lindner is there. Messier went down. He got hit. Oh, did he just paid him back? Mark Messier got hit and knocked down, and he made the recipient pay. That's Mark right. Here comes the hit there. It's a good hit, shoulder hit, but Mark is a veteran player. He knows. Maybe you want to do that to him.
Oh!
And there's an elbow right to the kisser. Hits a major, and he's gone. And Herr's over at the bench and looks to be okay, I think. Oh, maybe not. He's got his helmet mask off.
Horkoff controls. Fowler finds a little open space and lobs it rink wide. Knocked out of midair by Silverberg, who now pursues it. Gunnarsson waits for the pressure. Tries to protect him. Oh, Horkoff came in, and he finished. Oh, wow.
And blow the play dead immediately. Here it is. There's Tarasenko, and in comes Horkoff like a freight train. And Tarasenko was caught with the head up all the way. And it's the left arm of Horkoff that hits Tarasenko right on the block.